Deep into the night of September 10th, 1972, in Munich, the men's Olympic basketball gold medal came down to one game, the Soviet Union and the United States.
These were the two strongest countries in the world fighting for supremacy, and, you know, basketball was ours. We were the king, and there's no doubt that, you know, we wanted to make sure that that message was sent.
In the game's last half minute, the Americans had cut the Soviet lead to one, and then the Soviets gave Doug Collins one last golden chance. At age 21, Collins calmly tied the game at 49, and then, just as confidently, he put the United States up by one. The clock showed 3 seconds left. But as Collins lined up for his second foul shot, things around him had started to unravel. The Soviet coaches called frantically for a timeout.
And then as I was handed the ball to shoot the second free throw, if you really listen to the tape, you'll be able to hear as I start to shoot my second free throw, the horn goes off. And what has happened is the Soviet coach has tried to get a timeout. And you're not allowed to get a timeout in that situation. So the referee waves it off, no timeout.
As the ball dropped through, the Bulgarian referee signaled the teams to play on. At midcourt, the Soviet coaching staff screams for time. As the ball reached midcourt, the Brazilian referee stops play with 1 second left, and he seems to acknowledge the timeout, pointing to the Soviet bench.
It's the Russian coach and the players frantically running up and down the sideline trying to get a stoppage of play and a timeout, which worked because they stopped the game. Now that should have been a technical foul. You're not allowed off the bench.
While Hank Iba argued with the officials, into the lower left of your screen comes Dr. William Jones, the head of the International Basketball Federation. Jones signaled with three fingers the time left. In truth, Jones had no authority in this situation, but the decision had been made. Even though the referees apparently agreed the timeout buzzer was a mistake, the PA announced a reset of the clock to 3 seconds.
3 seconds.
The tragedy of errors then continued. While the scorer's table was resetting the clock, one referee hurried to start play. At the bottom of the screen, an official at the scorer's table waved frantically in an attempt to stop him, but to no avail. The Soviets inbound, and almost immediately, the apparent final buzzer goes off.
We celebrate on that court. People emptied out, came on the stands, came out of the stands onto the court. The court was full of fans jumping around, flags were waving, and for the first time, it hit us what it meant to win a gold medal.
But the clock had never been reset to 3 seconds. The PA announcer tried to clear the floor.
There are another 3 seconds less.
And the Americans were told, one by one, that the game wasn't over after all.
People would say, why didn't you leave? That we were told that if we left, we would have to forfeit. So we were sort of pushed back out on the floor.
With the clock finally reset at 3 seconds, the Americans tried to patch together their defense.
I saw the ball heading long, and I just started running towards it, towards the basket. And that's when I just jumped up and tried to get it. And so I was, if you see pictures, I'm just kind of flying by, out of bounds.
In a bizarre reversal from the American celebration a few moments earlier, the Soviets were now delirious, the Americans devastated.